Well, it's July in Florida, which means one thing, it's hot. And this year, no exception. With the heat comes possible health problems, including dehydration, exhaustion, and heat stroke. Here with some ways to beat the heat and stay healthy this summer, Dr. Anthony Magnano with St. Vincent's Medical Center, Riverside. Doctor, thank you for joining us. I appreciate it.
Thanks for the invitation.
Heat stroke, dehydration, they're real. What does it do to the body when this starts happening?
Okay, so there's two main effects of hot temperature on the body. First, we overheat, and second, we can become dehydrated. So when the body is exposed to a very hot environment, we need to dissipate that heat. Our core temperature needs to stay constant, close to that 98.6 we talk about. To do that, we dilate little blood vessels so the skin can get a little bit more red, and that's the body delivering the heat to the surface so it can dissipate.
That's why we're so flushed, it looks like, when
that's part of it.
Hot, yeah.
And then the second thing that happens is we sweat. Our sweat glands produce sweat. That's basically water with some salts. It goes on the skin surface, and when it evaporates, that's a very powerful cooling effect.
So my options are what, particularly if I have to be out in the heat for a barbecue or I'm working or what?
Yeah, well, we want to avoid those adaptive mechanisms going awry. So in other words, we need to make sure that we don't become victims of heat exhaustion or heat stroke. So we do need to stay very well hydrated, both before the activity and during it. We need to avoid being in the peak heat, so we need to keep an eye on the heat index as well as the temperature outside. Stay cool, avoid the peak hours.
So heat index is as important as temperature.
It is as important because it accounts for humidity. So it corrects it to say that our humidity is 20%. So if the humidity is in fact 80% or even higher, as it usually is in Florida, the heat index can be much higher. It's what it feels like to us.
So possible problem groups, heart conditions, elderly, maybe small children, what are some things they want to know? Because that can affect the heart.
For sure. So kids, especially under four, they don't feel that their body is having this effect. So they may not recognize the signs. Over 65, again, a vulnerable group. People with heart disease are a certain population that we want to watch for, because any stress is more likely to precipitate a cardiac event in those patients.
And just being hot is considered a stressor.
It definitely is a stressor. And also a lot of heart patients or people with hypertension might be on diuretics where they're already becoming a little bit dehydrated, or they may be on other medications that impair the body's ability to dissipate heat properly.
And do you see a lot of cases like these ever pop up? I mean, what shows up in your office or in an emergency room when this pops up?
Well, the emergency department is the key place. So at St. Vincent's, in our emergency department, we'll treat many heat-related illnesses each summer. You want to watch for dizziness, lightheadedness, extreme thirst, palpitations, nausea, cramping. They can be a sign of heat exhaustion. But then as the body becomes dehydrated, can't sweat anymore, the skin may become dry, the thirst may go away, and it can proceed to what we call heat stroke, where the temperature can go above 104 degrees, and you can go become lethargic, go into a coma, become seizing, or even die.
And so if I'm watching someone, a family member, an older family member, or a younger family member, those things I want to look for too?
Absolutely, in everybody, and especially in those populations, yeah.
Dr. Magnano, thank you so much. Very important right now because it is so hot this summer.
It is really
hot. It is as hot as I've seen in quite a while. So thank you, doctor. Very important stuff to hear. This is important information we want to make sure everyone knows about. We'll post the interview to the Morning Show page of news4jax.com. Make sure to share it with your loved ones.